Desmopressin is a synthetic analog of vasopressin that acts on V2 receptor and is used in treatment of a variety of medical conditions. Desmopressin acts on vasopressin V2 receptor. V2 receptor is GS protein coupled receptor. This means that with activation it stimulates adenylate cyclase that in response to this converts ATP into cyclic AMP. So activation of V2 receptor causes increase in intracellular cyclic AMP level, and from this point everything depends on the site of action. In our organism we have two major tissues that have V2 receptor. It's kidney tissue and blood vessels. V2 receptors are present on epithelial cells in renal collecting ducts, and also they are present on endothelial cells of the blood vessels. In collecting ducts, increase in cyclic AMP induce increase in amount of aquaporin molecules on epithelial surface. With increase in amount of aquaporins in collecting ducts, the absorption of water increase, and thereby it decrease the volume of the urine and simultaneously increase urine osmolarity. To illustrate this, there is epithelial cells of the renal collecting duct. The function of the epithelium in the collecting duct is water absorption. And water absorption is provided by aquaporins, which are basically pores that can absorb water by osmotic gradient. But the specific feature of aquaporins is that initially they are present in inactivated state inside the epithelial cells. The signal that forces transportation of aquaporins to epithelial surface is increase in concentration of acyclic AMP. So when we prescribe desmopressin, it will activate the V2 receptor. V2 receptor is GS coupled, so in response to activation, it will stimulate adenylate cyclase to convert ATP into cyclic AMP. So this will cause increase in cyclic AMP level inside the cell. And the higher the cyclic AMP concentration, the more aquaporin molecules will be transported to the surface of epithelial cell. With increase in amount of aquaporin molecules on epithelial surface, water absorption increase, and the higher the water absorption, the lesser volume of fluid will be left in the lumen of the collecting ducts, and thereby the lesser volume of fluid will be excreted by the urine. And also the lesser the volume of fluid, the higher the concentration of osmotically active substances, and thereby the higher the urine osmolarity. So desmopressin effect on kidney tissue cause decrease in urine volume and increase in urine osmolarity. In relation to endothelial cells, increase in cyclic AMP induce exocytosis of endothelial cells. First of all, it causes exocytosis of von Willebrand factor, and thereby this causes increase in the level of von Willebrand factor in the blood. And also this causes exocytosis of factor VIII. As we know, factor VIII provides secondary hemostasis, so by increasing amount of factor VIII, we can improve secondary hemostasis. Von Willebrand factor has two functions. The major function is that von Willebrand factor provides platelets adhesion in primary hemostasis. So desmopressin by exocytosis of von Willebrand factor can improve primary hemostasis. But the minor function of the von Willebrand factor is that von Willebrand factor serves as a protein carrier for factor VIII. So the higher will be the amount of von Willebrand factor in the blood, the higher will be the amount of activated factor VIII, and thereby the higher will be the activity of the secondary hemostasis. Because desmopressin causes decrease in urine volume, this drug is the treatment option in case of diabetes insipidus and nocturnal polyuria. Because desmopressin increases the amount of von Willebrand factor in the blood, it's a drug of choice in the treatment of Willebrand disease. Also, because desmopressin causes release of von Willebrand factor and factor VIII, this drug is frequently used in treatment of hemophilia A. The major adverse effect of desmopressin is hyponatremia. The reason why hyponatremia develops is that with increase in water absorption, the amount of fluid in the blood increase, but simultaneously the concentration of ions as sodium decrease. So at some point relative hyponatremia develops. And hyponatremia can be very dangerous because it can precipitate seizures, and severe seizures can even cause death. If you like content, please press like and subscribe button. All the best!